It's something you likely see every day in every part of town, but how much do you really know about it?
Metro Police say much of the graffiti has a meaning to it. In a WLKY investigation, Eric King sits down with an undercover detective to crack the graffiti code.
Consider it the original social media. I tag you, you tag me, we check in here. But this surveillance video taken in Tyler Park points out a major difference. This is criminal.
Tagging graffiti is used to gain fame with others who are into tagging. Tagging usually shows the name of the tagger, name, moniker, or nickname.
Some call it art. But this detective, whose identity and voice we're hiding for his own safety, calls it first-degree criminal mischief. But, like the fumes of the paint, the two men vanish into thin air. In June, Kevin Wilson was not so lucky. Police arrested and charged him with a felony, saying he, along with Cody Curry, tagged at least 15 different places. Despite the $100,000-a-year taxpayer investment in night vision cameras, the arrest was rare.
I've seen quite a bit in most of the corner houses, where, you know, garages, and mostly in the alleys where they spray paint. Well, nobody can see them while they're doing it, I think.
Jesse Hatchett has lived here in Louisville's West End since 1969. To him, graffiti isn't new, but the type he sees gives him more fear than the crest and initials of the Tyler Park taggers.
I think a lot of it is gang lingo, you know, they have their own meaningful words.
Metro Police say these are gang markings.
Gang graffiti is used to designate gang territory, gang affiliation, gang members, and oftentimes tell a story about what's going on with the gang at that time.
I'm concerned.
What are you concerned about?
Well, you know, you never know what they are planning. You know, you look around and all kind of stuff going on in the streets, like over 32nd and Kentucky earlier, Greenwood, when all this shooting broke out, you know. Those things you can't, you know, predict.
It's not been confirmed that those shootings had anything to do with gang activity, but Metro Police do confirm the area in which it happened has a visible level of gang activity. And it didn't take us long to find it. Take a look at this. DSG 17 through 23rd. Metro Police say it's a territory marking for the gang known as Doom Squad Generals, also known in some circles as the Victory Park Crips, claiming the area of 17th Street all the way to 23rd.
It was real nice back in the day, but now it's got ugly, man. It has really got to the point where these youngsters have tried to take over. Not so.
Is graffiti a sign of that?
Sure it is. Sure it is.
When it comes to gang graffiti, that's just the surface of it. Tonight at 11, we'll take a look inside gang symbols and alphabets and show you how you can translate their meanings. Also, cleaning it all up, you might be surprised to find out whose responsibility it is. We'll see you at 11.